Okay, so on Friday, which is today, a kid in my class was acting kind of weird. He was, like, walking with his head down and not talking much, staying to himself, but he usually talks. I approached him and he just said to let him be. Then the teacher said that he had his spirits down. Does that mean he's a ghost? That would be kind of cool. Well, how you think I could help? Thank you.
As if it wasn't bad enough that you woke me from a very good sleep, now I have to hear more of this sneepity snooper whatever. It's sneepy and snoopy. I-E. At the end.
Keep on making these,
Snippity beepies.
Please keep on making these nicknames, because we really like them.
It's just great. Firstly, it brings me... Hold me.
Today's memory Bible verse is Genesis 37:5. One night, Joseph had a dream. And when he told his brothers about it, they hated him more than ever. Genesis 37:5.
Let's repeat that. Genesis 37:5.
One night, Joseph had a dream, and when he told his brothers about it, they hated him more than ever. Genesis 37:5.
So deep, with so much hatred.
Please stand for the opening song of I Got Shoes by VeggieTales!
I'm so weak. You need help? Oh! Are you referring to this one?
Shoes, I'm gonna walk all over God's heaven. Heaven, heaven. Everybody's talking about heaven. I'm going there. Heaven, heaven. I'm gonna walk all over God's heaven.
Yeah, that's the one, but I don't think you're singing it quite right. Let me take a whack at it.
I got a rope, you got a rope. All God's children got a rope. When I get to heaven, gonna put on my robe and gonna shout all over
God's heaven. In my robe,
heaven, heaven. Everybody's talking about heaven. I'm going there, heaven, heaven. I'm gonna shout all over God's heaven.
I heard you guys go out and sing that song. Let me have a turn.
I got wings, and you got wings, all God's children got wings. When I get to heaven, gonna open up my wings, I'm gonna fly all over God's heaven. God's heaven, heaven. Everybody's talking about heaven, I'm going there. Heaven, heaven, I'm gonna fly.
Big dream. Can you hold Chewy, please? the soft, fuzzy monkey. I'm ready in a minute, Maestro.
Soft and fuzzy.
Yes, he actually is pretty fuzzy.
Still attacked me.
Don't worry. Okay, hit it, Maestro.
Big Dreams, based on Genesis 37. When Isaac dies, Jacob takes over as head of the tribe. He settles his family in his father's land of Canaan. His sons take care of his flocks of sheep. But one day, Joseph tells his father how his other sons have been misbehaving while out in the field.
I am ashamed of all of you. I need you to be responsible, like your little brother Joseph.
It's okay, Dad. That's what I'm here for.
Oh, Joseph, you really are a special kid.
There goes Father with his favorite son.
I can't believe he told on us. What's next? Father puts him in charge of the flocks?
I'll never take orders from Joseph.
One day, Jacob gives his beloved son a special gift.
Your father had this coat made just for you.
From Ephton's robe.
The next time Joseph goes out to the fields, he shows off his new coat. His brothers become even more jealous. But that is nothing compared to how they feel when Joseph says,
"This reminds me, I had a dream last night. We were all bundling grain. When we finished, all your mine.
Bow down to you? Never."
But Joseph doesn't get the hint.
"I had another dream. This time, the sun, moon, and stars bowed down to me."
"Joseph, stop your boasting. Do you really think your parents and brothers will serve you? Could this dream really be from God?"
Jacob soon forgets his own anger towards Joseph, but the second dream whips the rage.
"He thinks he's a star, huh? I'll show him how far a star can fall."
So deep.
Dreamer for Sale, based on Genesis chapter 37.
Which is our next week's Bible story. Yep, Dreamer for Sale. Time for the Bible story reflection. What did we learn? Well, first, one, try to keep your spirit up, like Joseph did, so you won't turn into a ghost. I'm just kidding. Trust in God at all times. And also, don't be afraid to share your thoughts, dreams, and or feelings.
Time for the summary by
Snoopy.
Oh,
that
was
a
Snoopy.
Oh, it's okay.
Okay, so it's about Jacob when he has his 12 sons. Joseph is the honorary favorite. And he ends up tattletaling on his brothers when they're misbehaving and fooling around in the fields. And his brothers become very, very jealous of him. And just to make things matters worse, he gets a coat and they get even more jealous. And then, even after all that, you think it gone too far? Nope! He goes on to tell his stories to them and they get too jealous. They've gone too fuming, too angry to just burst out of the furnace, okay? And they throw him in a bit. In a pit. And that's where the next story takes off. The next story takes off there. Okay, next week's story is Dreamer for Sale, as we said a few moments ago. Okay, time for the Bible trivia of the day. Question one. Why were Joseph's brothers jealous? His boasting, quote unquote, which were really actually visions, and his coat, and his father's favoritism. Oh yeah, and his dreams, I forgot. His dreams. Dreams.
Okay, let's see. Because he was the favorite, and he was loved more.
And so, also because of his dreams.
Found in Genesis 37:4. Question 2. Who made plans to kill Joseph? His brothers, because they were pretty jealous.
Even a jealous person wouldn't do that.
Well, maybe. Well, maybe if they had rage also. Or, not rage.
I mean, Jacob and Esau kind of had that. He was, Esau was enraged and he wanted to kill him, I guess.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Still iffy. Still iffy.
His brothers! We got a raid! But also, that's bad.
Found in Genesis 37, 18.
Don't worry. I get that you're tired.
But so I can sleep now?
Actually, no. Question 3. Who was Jacob sold to? This is a tricky one.
Barbarians.
What?
Barbarians.
That's right. So barbaric.
Did you say you're barber?
Barber?
Well, yes.
Imagine if that was a barbarian.
Yes, thank you. Actually, I got a haircut this week, so yeah, thank you. Nice. Thank you. Actually, my barber did say that he was the best barbarian of his time. His apparently he had a father who was a barbarian. It was a very famous guy. He made all these wimpy hairstyles and he went around the world.
I think I know his name. Barabbas!
Yes. That has to be it, Oh.
Ahem. Anywho.
That really is barbaric, but I gotta say.
Totally!
Okay, let's
see. Okay, what's the answer, Maestro?
Hit it.
Potiphar. Found in Genesis 37 and 36.
We'll learn who he is later.
Yes. Challenge Bible trivia for the day. What will happen to all the arrogant and every evil doer in the end of time?
Oh, they're thrown into a fiery pit or furnace,
like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego?
Maybe. Or maybe they're just brutally punished.
Maybe there's a river of fire and they're all thrown in there for eternity to burn. The answer is found in Malachi 4:1, and this is actually a quote.
All the arrogant and every evildoer will be stubbled.
And the day that is coming will set them on fire, says the Lord Almighty. Not a root or a branch will be left to them. Ooh, that's very...
That's something.
I'm speechless right now. I can't even think. Time for the New Testament song. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts, and Romans. 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, Galatians, and Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, 1 and 2 Timothy, Titus, and Philemon, Hebrews, James, 1 and 2 Peter, 1 and 2 and 3 John, Jude, and Revelation.
Good job!
You okay?
I gave it everything I had.
You're okay. The next song is My God Is So Big by VeggieTales. Please stand.
I got it. Okay.
Wow.
That hurt me.
A lot.
What?
That actually helped you.
I got this. Don't touch me.
Don't touch me. Okay.
My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do
for you.
The mountains are his, the rivers are his, the stars are his, and they work too.
So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you.
In a letter
so much for this show. You're okay. Don't worry. Okay, time for the joke of the day. Number one. Is the chemical symbol for the holy water H2OMG?
Come on, I already had science, okay? I don't need more science. I feel like crouching down and going to sleep, okay?
Maybe.
Religion comes at a price.
But it's a small price to pray. Price to pray.
That's funny. I can't believe that. Well, it might take a minute for the next one to come on, so in the meantime, I guess I'll just snooze.
You can sit down now.
What was I just doing?
I don't know.
As we finish today, don't forget what we learned about spirits. Remember, God's always got your back. Fake it till you get there. God will see you through.
Fake. Sleep time.
No matter what you lose in life, nobody can take the joy of the Lord from you unless you freely give it away by getting rid of it. Amen.
Spirits are actually very, very, very real things. Spirits are real things, people.
Yeah, they can.
They are very real things.
We'll go into it a little later, but...
In our next show, we will look more into the spirits, if you want to see that.
Yep.
Right now, I need to sleep.
Okay.
Don't touch me, okay?
He was feeling the emotion of sadness, and sadness is a feeling of, just like in the last time that we talked, I believe, I don't remember, I'm still sleepy, but, you know, you feel sad over little things and big things. Maybe you lost something in a video game, or you lost something small, like a little toy or something. Or something like that. But a big thing might be losing a family member. Or your parents have something going on and you end up getting in the middle of it and you're just not yourself. Also, that's sometimes how a lot of bullies from like schools start coming up too. Because stuff's either happening at home or something happened to them. And it just makes them feel better to bully others.
Yeah.
And that's actually true, because people get bullied, because that's life.
And they get sleepy.
What? Well, everybody gets sleepy, but like... Oh, I also have another way to keep your spirits up. You know how Snoopy is always saying that he doesn't want you guys to give us nicknames? Well, keep your spirits and be positive and start thinking of new nicknames to write in letters.
I heard that. Stop with the names, okay?
Don't stop with the names.
I'm gonna...
Stay positive.
I'm gonna...
Time for the final thought of our show. You are loved. You are wonderfully made. You are beautiful. You have a purpose. You are a masterpiece. And God has a great plan for you.
Say it with us.
I am loved. I am wonderfully made. I am beautiful. I have a purpose. I am a masterpiece. And God has a great plan for you.
Say it one more time.
I am loved. I am wonderfully made. I am beautiful. I have a purpose. I am a masterpiece. And God has a great plan for you and me and all of you out there.
Join us on the next time in the Snoopy
and Sneaky
Show for another wonderful Bible story. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel.
Write comments in the chat if you have any prayers or suggestions.
Don't forget to subscribe.
Oh, also, inside of the comments, please give us some new ideas for nicknames.
Subscribe!
Wait, what? No nicknames.
Nicknames! No nicknames.
We want nicknames! 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 Nicknames!
All right, how about this?
Anything you got!
You can come up with the corniest, passing out, I'm running out, camera, thing, joke, type Snoopy and Sneepy things. If you subscribe! Subscribe to the channel! It helps us!
Why am I in this accent? Okay. Time for the final prayer.
By you?
Yes.
No, by an animal. Dear Lord, we come before your...
I didn't mean...
Dear Lord, we come before your presence. We give you honor and thanks, Lord, for everything you've done for us today. Lord, we thank you for this good time that you've given us to be good and learn more about you. And I hope that we have a wonderful rest of our day or night. And that we have a good day or night. And that we all learn more about you on this wonderful show. This corny, weird names and all that.
Amen. Stole my spot.
Leave it in the
booth. Oh. Oh, yeah, please. Oh. Okay. Don't worry,
I'm gonna get you one day.
Okay, let's do the last song. If I can make it that far.
I just tooted.
You ready?
No.
Yes, but sure, we're ready.
Okay, now I'm ready. Thank you.